Alrighty, welcome in everyone. How are you today? I am kind of like all over the place. How is everyone today? How are you doing? Happy Friday. What's up, everyone? Your girl's a little all over the place. I thought I was sitting here. I was like, I'm gonna play some Poppy's Playtime in honor of Poppy's Playtime 3. And I was like, okay. I downloaded it and everything right before stream. And then I was like, wait a minute. I wanted to share something with you guys. I'm probably going to be going to Disney this weekend. So I was like, man, I really wanted to like review the festival food with you guys and stuff like that. And like my mind was going like 50 directions. And I was like, man, I'm wanting to play some Poppy. I want to play some Pow World. I don't really know what we're going to do today, but I'm going to stick with my original plan and we'll play Poppy on Monday. How are you, dude? Welcome in. Welcome back. Welcome in, J-Girl. Welcome in, Sonata. And welcome in, Tay. Welcome in, Cookie. How is everyone doing today? I'm super excited. I'm going to be going, I believe, to the art festival this weekend. So, it's Pow World. So, what you playing? I think we're playing Pow World. Cookie messaged me and is like, wait, what are we playing today? I'm like, I'm pretty sure we're playing Pow World. But I was going to share some stuff with you about Disney, because this is a new segment I'm probably going to bring to the channel. So Epcot Disney has like festivals every month or every few months. And I was like, I kind of want to like share that with you guys. Like some of the stuff that I go and do. So today we're going to be looking at some food, and then afterwards, if we have time, we're going to be playing some Pow World. But I was going to get into that. Like, that was like the original plan today before I was like, Poppy's Playtime! Hey, you got a bean sprout, J-Girl, let's go. But yeah, we'll probably be playing Poppy on Monday. Poppy's Playtime 2, I think it's coming out on Poppy's Playtime 3 is coming out on, I think, Tuesday. If I'm not mistaken, I'm going to take a look into it and see if it's appropriate for the channel. I don't know if it's going to be appropriate for the channel, but we may play, one on Monday. We'll see how it goes, but I got to do some looking into the third one. The third one looks like it's going to be slightly darker than the other ones. So we just got to kind of, you know what I mean? We got to see where it's going to line up, because I saw one trailer for it and I was like, I don't know if we can play this on stream. And then like the last trailer I saw, it looked okay, but one of the first ones that came out, it looked a little too much for the channel, so we'll see how it goes. But yeah, I'm gonna dive into that a little bit more and we'll figure it out over on the weekend. But right now, I was going to show you guys some festival food, and I figured you guys might be kind of interested in this because it's something like that I enjoy, and I mean, who doesn't enjoy food? But we will probably be playing some Pal World after, so stay tuned for that. All right, let's get into it. But without further ado, if anyone has any questions or any topics you guys want to talk about, let me know. We're free to talk about anything today, you know? We're just chilling like a villain. Alrighty. Relic, welcome in. Thank you so much for being here. How are you, dude? How's your Friday going? Is there any possibility I could load Power World while you do Disney? Yeah, that's fine. Oh, wait. One second. One second. Sorry. All right, let me turn my PlayStation like screen on so it doesn't like blind you guys. I'll load up Power World really quick. Are you? I'm totally down to do that. That's okay with me. But if anyone wants to get into the Power World, world, just let me know. We'll get you in. That's totally fine. I'm okay with that. How are you doing today, Relic? What's going on with you? Let's load that in. Yeah, I'm totally down to do that. If people want to get in and play some Power World, like, that's totally fine. Forest start game. And I'll post the chat and let's play. Let's go. I don't have it, so you guys have fun. Yeah. We're gonna be playing, we're gonna be looking at Disney food first. So the schedule is we're gonna be looking at Disney's food first. Oh, Power World's not loading for me, Cookie. It's crashing. We may not be able to do that. Sorry, Cookie. It's crashing the system. Like, it just crashed in the middle of trying to open up. So we're just gonna stay here. All right. So, we are gonna be looking, yeah, unfortunately, we're gonna be looking for at the 2024 Epcot Festival of the Food. And I'm super excited to show you guys some food, 'cause like if you guys ever wonder like what like the festivals are, I was like, I kind of want to show you guys. Not the whole what, just revisiting my Drago Age Origin. Oh, okay. Suing Nintendo. I know, really, it's honestly Nintendo's fault. So I'm probably gonna be going to the festival tomorrow, hopefully. But I figured I'd show you guys some food. So these are the tables. They have like these little booths set up all around Epcot. And I figured I'd show you guys this because it's pretty cool, pretty fun to like look at the food and stuff. And like I do this every time. So this is what the booth looks like. So this is the artisan table. So they have like kind of like artsy kind of food. And so let's take a look here at the menu. Let's see what we got. Duck and dumpling. That looks pretty good. I've actually never had duck before. So if you've had duck, let me know in the chat. Like, is duck good? That looks pretty good to me. Then we had some hummingbird cake. If you've never had this, this is super, super good. I feel like this is kind of like a southern dish, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. But that looks really good to me. Yo, what's up, JT? Welcome in. My younger sister had duck, really? It's cursed. That is so cursed. How are you, JT? But yeah, hummingbird cake is super, super good. I can't remember like all what hummingbird cake actually is. I know it has nuts in it. Hummingbird cake is banana pecans dipped in cream cheese icing with caramel sauce and warm pineapple component. Ooh. That actually sounds super, super, super good. I don't know. What do you guys think about this food? And let me know what you think about this segment on the channel. These are beverages that you can get. They sell spicy drinks. But yeah, this is what this booth has. And this all looks super, super good. Like how they give the ingredients. Yeah, that's something else I was gonna say. Like, they give the ingredients. So the duck is duck and dumplings. It's smoked duck, breast ricotta dumplings, baby vegetables, and duck. I don't know what that means. I don't know what that is. And then they give you like the prices and stuff.
Bye, have a great time.
Hey, thank you so much for the lurk. Good, how's everyone doing? We're doing pretty good. We're just chilling. We're talking about the festival. So if you're interested in like knowing about the festival and stuff, we're just talking about the food and stuff pretty much today. I figured that would be fun for today. So yeah, that's what this this booth has. And then normally you can just go back and then you can just look at the next one. Well, I mean, they need to keep in mind the allergies. Yeah, so Disney's really, really good about allergies. Disney's very, very good about allergies. They always have, like, the information and stuff like that. So this is the Craftsman's Courtyard. They have two things, it looks like, this year. They have, let's see, grilled pork belly with salsa verde, some broccoli, some peppers, different things like that. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, absolutely. And it looks like they have a steak here. I've heard that this was super, super good. This one doesn't look super good to me, the pork belly, but I've heard that this was, like, one of the best of the fest this year. And that's another picture of it, like, the whole thing. And then they have, like, the steak little burger here. Looks pretty good. And then they have the drinks down here, but we're not going to look at the drinks. But yeah, these are the two things that they have at this booth. And I was like, man, like, that looks pretty good to me. But I don't know if I'm going to get this or not. But it's not a horrible price. So this one, the pork belly comes in at $6 and then the steak comes in at $7. So normally, like, with these, like, festivals and booths and stuff like that, they're, like, relatively low prices because you're just basically trying, like, portion sizes of, like, these, like, individual, like, things. But I figured I'd show you guys since I'm going this weekend. Let's see. All right. I don't know if this is, like, a particular country. I don't think it is. But we'll take a look really quick. It looks like they have a beef Wellington with us and a cast iron roast PEI... Oh, I think I know what this is. I think I know. So this is one of the best things at the festival. I've actually never had it because it's a little bit more expensive than most of the other things. It's like $8 here. So I normally don't get this. But like, I kind of want to try this. Let's see. This is super, if you like seafood, this is really, really, really good. My husband really, really likes like this like mussel dish. And if anyone likes seafood, I'm not a seafood girly, but this is a pretty good one. I has my tweet, so I'm a good auntie because she'll eat, yes, Rice Krispie treats. Yes, absolutely. But yeah, that looks pretty good. This one, I didn't try any of this because I don't really like mussels and stuff like that. So it's like, it's not my thing, you know what I mean? All right, we got the Deco Dessert Delights. Okay. So this is a booth that I really, really enjoy going to. And they have like a trio cheesecake. So I normally go and get this. But mind you, like they're different almost every year. So like it's not going to be the same. Like this dessert palette was like totally different last year. But this is what this year's looks like. And this looks pretty good. Let's take a look and see what they are. We got a chocolate tart. I'm assuming that that's this one right here. And a vanilla bean cheesecake. I'm assuming that this might be the cheesecake. And mine too, Spark shows it. Yes, absolutely, Spark. Oh, this last year was like something lemony. I don't know what it was. And then we got a strawberry mousse. This one looks pretty good. I'm assuming this was the strawberry mousse and that this right here has to be like the, I'm assuming this is the just the cheesecake itself. But yeah, I'm probably going to end up getting this dessert right here and I'll probably eat these two and then my husband will eat the chocolate because I don't like chocolate. They're heavy nibbling on them. Yes, that looks yummy. Yeah, I'm really like, that's the one I want. And then you get this for like $5. So this one's a pretty good like little deal. I actually like that. Yes, I will send some digitally to you. I'll make sure to post all the pictures. Okay, the deconstructed dishes. This is pretty cool. So normally what they do with these like like these dishes is they literally deconstruct them and they make them look like what they're not supposed to be, but they are. So let's see what they got this year. So they have a BLT, they have a key lime pie. Just the, okay. All right, so let's see. So this looks like the BLT. So they take apart the dishes normally and they serve them in ways that are like a little bit different than what you would think. And I've had some stuff from here, but I haven't tried this one. I know that. Be right back. Okay, all good. But I think this would be pretty good. Like this right here. That looks pretty good to me. And then we have the key lime pie. Apparently this right here is all the rage this year. And I'm not like super big on like key lime pies and stuff like that. But it looks pretty good. Like I kind of want this. I'm assuming that this is the key lime filling right here. And then the graham cracker is probably these two things. And then here's the meringue. But that would be kind of weird to have like a big like ball of graham cracker right here, you know? That'd be super weird. But I like it. I'm still not convinced to get... I don't know if I'm convinced to get this. This is at $7, and then this is like $6.50. So I'm not sure if I'm quite convinced yet to get anything from this one, but what do you guys think in the chat? If you guys have any, like, you know, thoughts, comments, let me know what you guys are thinking. We got a strawberry mint drink. Apparently, this is non-spicy. That looks a little crazy to me. I don't know what that is. Last year, they had, like, an apple pie drink. That one was a little bit wild. That one was pretty good, though. It was, like, a frozen apple pie drink. And I don't know how to explain it, but it was pretty good. I actually super, super liked it. This must be... Yeah, this must be Mexico. Yeah, the Mexico Pavilion. The Mexico Pavilion always gets good hype just because their food is normally super, super, super good. Let's see what they got this year. Let's see. Carne asada. That's not like the best picture they could have had, but it looks pretty good. And then a tostada. That looks pretty chill. Like, I would be okay with that. That looks pretty good. I'm never, like, a super fan of the Mexican Pavilion. But it always pops off. Like, every festival, no matter what festival they have, the Mexican Pavilion always does so incredibly well. This is... I don't think this is a country, this one in particular. This is at one of the buildings, if I'm not mistaken. Let's see. They have some, like, super, super, like, aesthetically pleasing stuff normally here, I think. So we got a Pop-Tart here. I'm not too big on the Pop-Tarts. And then we got a rainbow Skittle cake. That looks super good. I've never actually had this, but a part of me wants to try it. But then a part of me doesn't, like, actually really like cake, like, a lot of cake. So I don't know if I'd like that or not. Yo, welcome in! We're doing a review on the Disney, on the food festival. So feel free to comment if you are a foodie. but how are you today? The cure is Jesus. How are you? You can get a popcorn bucket here, which is super, super cute. And then you can also get like a grape freeze Skittle smoothie. Like this one's a little bit wild to me. I don't know if I would eat, drink this. I like grape stuff, but I don't know if I want that. It has like foam and stuff on it. I don't know. This one's a little bit crazy to me. Hey, Pikachu and everyone, I tell you that Pop-Tarts are yummy. Yeah, this one, I don't know what flavor this one. And this is a blueberry filled pastry tart with purple icing. That's okay. Like, I don't know if this would be like my... I'm just not a big fan of Pop-Tarts. Like, I ate a lot of them, like, as a kid. So, I don't know if I would, like, actually like them that much. Alright, this is the... This is the... I'm like over here having like a stroke. This is the Japan Pavilion. I normally get stuff at the Japan Pavilion. I'm struggling so hard today. Your girl was all messed up today. Like, my roadmap was like going crazy today. We got a Wagyu bun, so it has some Wagyu beef. Words. What are those? I don't know. I'm struggling. I haven't had the Wagyu beef bun, but that looks super, super good. I love, like, bowl buns, so this is probably gonna be super good. That's the inside. I love how they get, like, the outside super, super flaky. Then we have a sushi donut. I think I've actually had this one time. It's super aesthetically pleasing, like, when you see it on your plate. If you like sushi, that is. And then we get the mochi. I'm pretty sure that this is, like, strawberry mochi. I really, really want to try this one. Like, I'm probably gonna get this one at the festival. And then we have some blueberry drink. This is non-alcoholic, I'm pretty sure. But that looks pretty good to me. I'm not, like, you know, I don't drink and stuff. So I really, really enjoy, like, whenever a booth has, like, something that's not a spicy water drink. You know what I mean? The boba looks delicious. The bowel? Yes, doesn't it? You should come down for the festival, you know what I mean, Tay? But yeah, that looks super, super, super good. Like, the Wagyu in there. The sushi donut. Like, I actually might splurge and get this year. Let's take a look at these prices. Let's see how much they actually are. Oh, the bun. That one's super expensive. Normally, I don't buy dishes that are above $9, but I kind of want to try that, you know? The sushi donut is expensive, too, this year. This used to be, like, $6 or $7. Now it's up to $8. I don't know about all that. But this drink, I don't know, man. I kind of want to... That looks pretty good. I don't know, man. All right. I'm not really sure what pavilion this is. Let me double check. This kind of looks like it's... I was going to say Canada before I even saw this. I was like, this kind of looks like Canada. Canada normally has a pretty good selection. I don't normally get, like, a whole lot from Canada. But this apparently is super, super good. I don't even know what this is. It is... Let's see. Roast beets with goat cheese, petite lettuce. This is like... Okay, so there's, like, no meat. So this is like a baby charcuterie board. It looks pretty good to me, but I don't really like mushrooms, but I want to like these mushrooms, but I don't like mushrooms, but I want to like them because they just look cool. This looks super good. Roasted bone marrow. I've actually never had, like, roasted bone marrow, but I've been seeing it a lot over on, like, my TikTok and stuff. And, like, it kind of makes me want to try it, but then I'm like, would I actually like it? I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. Wild mushroom.
Look to the forest.
Yay. this is something I think they normally have this at the festival, but I've never actually tried that. Let's take a look at the prices, though. I'm really curious to see what this is. $10? Yo, I'm not buying that. Even though this is the one I want to try, the roasted bone marrow, I'm not paying $10 for that. But this one looks pretty good at $5. It's because it only has vegetables. Cookie, just trying to greet new peeps. Yes, yes. You should try it. The roasted bone marrow or this one? The vegetables? Like, yes, yes. Are you really new, though? Probably not. Probably not. The bone marrow, I want to try that. But, like, I normally don't spend over $7 on the booths. So, like, it's a little steep, but I still want to try it. All right. This is France. I am new. You're a liar. You're not new. This is France. I normally don't wait in the France line because the France line is super long normally. But I am curious. They have a lot of items here this year. This is always a hit. It's like a cheese bowl. So if you like cheese and bread, like, this is always a hit. if he does that already. I got this 1 year and I wasn't a big fan of it. I'm gonna be 100% honest. It wasn't like 100%, you know what I mean? Like, this wasn't my favorite, but I could understand how this is a favorite amongst people. I don't know how to say this. If you would like to pronounce this in your... Whoa, looks like cheese. Yay. If you want to try to pronounce this, you can. I can't even pronounce normal words, so I'm not even going to try to pronounce whatever this is. Or this. Your girl don't know what it is, but it looks pretty good. Oh, they're together. What? I'm so confused right now. I don't understand the words that are coming out of your mouth. What does it mean? Welcome, new critters and just viewers. Yes, yes, yes. Was recently. Yes, yes, yes. All right, I'm so confused as to what some of this is. Puff pastry with salmon, spinach. I don't know how to pronounce the rest of this. Served with warm sauce. Okay, that was the one that's like the... That's this one, I'm pretty sure. And then... This is a hot and cold. Enjoy both of the salmon... What? What even are these? France is so fancy this year. I can't pronounce half of the stuff on this list. And I probably won't be getting anything at this pavilion because I don't understand. Yo, welcome in, Dark. How are you, dude? I don't understand the words that are coming out of your mouth. I don't get it. But we'll go to Italy. Italy. I like Italy's booths normally, too. Meow. Welcome in. Italy normally has some pretty good stuff. But Italy is also one of the ones that is a long, long line normally. Today, if you're coming in and you're like, hey, Ibby, what are you doing? Today, we are reviewing the food, the art festival food over at Epcot and Disneyland, Disney World, Epcot, in Orlando, Florida. So if you're like, what are you doing? We're just looking at food because we do be liking food around here. Chili's Hoballs, yeah, it's been really good. Thank you so much for asking. Thank you so much for asking. We got this little art palette going on here. It's like a mozzarella. Like, this is a mozzarella thing, I think. And then it has different sauces you can, like, dip it in. Which is super interesting. I don't know about that one. We got some type of, like, I don't know what this is. It just looks like pasta to me. Your girl's just seeing pasta. It's pasta with meat inside. If you're Italian, I apologize. I don't understand a lot of dishes. I don't know what this is. Ibby likes food as she likes to cook pals in Pal World after beating him up. You're so cute. Well, everyone has 8 ads. I'm sorry, the ads are turned off. I haven't figured out my ad schedule. I took a picture of all the stuff OG sent me and I just haven't implemented it this week because I have to look over it and fix it. I'm sorry. Yeah, it looks like a stuffed shell. I don't know what that is, but that doesn't look too hot to me. I gotta know what this is, first of all. Looks like a PB&J cup of whipped cream and spicy chip, just what I see. I actually really like that. Chocolate cheesecake with whipped cream. That was easy. Have you ever heard of Twitch Prime? Yes, you too can use your Twitch Prime subscription. If you have a Twitch Prime, then you have... If you have Amazon Prime, you have a free Twitch subscription. All you have to do is link your account and then use it on your favorite creators. Sorry, your girl's... struggling over here. Baked stuff. I don't know how to say that. Pasta with beef, ricotta, peas. I would not get this. This does not sound good to me. Like, this right here, not good for me. And this was just chocolate cheesecake. That's all it was. It was just fancy cheesecake. That's it. It looks like what I described. It really does. It actually does look like that. You're like, it's a peanut butter cup with a hot Cheeto on it. I'm actually here for that. China's pavilion's normally pretty good. But Ibby trying stuff is how the world works. I understand. I do try a lot of things. Believe it or not, I try a good few things at these booths. I try a good few things at these booths normally. And like, I'm not always, like, persuaded. I would love to try that cheesecake. I love cheesecake. Oh, you should have seen the one before you got here. There was like a strawberry cheesecake and it was super. It didn't look like a cheesecake, but it looks super good. We got the painted panda over here. We got some General Tso chicken. I don't know how to say that. Then we get a pork bun and then sesame balls with red bean paste. These are normally really good. What is this? Oh, this is the chicken thing. Oh, I kind of want to try that. Rosie, welcome in, dude. How are you? Today, if you are just coming in, we are reviewing the food at the Epcot Festival for the art festival. We're just looking at the food. I'm probably going this weekend, so I was like, I'll show you guys what I get to see on the weekend. I'm probably going to end up getting that because that just looks aesthetically pleasing. I don't know what it is. Never had it, but I'm going to probably try that. Look at them. Look, they're like little hors d'oeuvres. Joshua. we got the pork bun here. I've had this before. It's pretty good. This is normally what they do is they'll bring back favorites. And they'll just change them up slightly. So that's what they kind of do for the festival. And then they bring all new things. Like this. I've never seen this at the festival before. So I'm excited for that one. This is the sesame balls with red bean paste. I think we've had these before. It was just like a different flavor. It wasn't red bean paste that was in them. It was something else, I'm pretty sure. But these are pretty good. If I'm not mistaken. Yeah, these are pretty good. They also have a black and white boba tea. That looks pretty good. I probably wouldn't get it if it's anything.
Bye, have a great time.
Okay, all good. Thank you for the lurk. I probably wouldn't get this if it's like super chocolatey. Yeah, that's. I probably wouldn't get this, but it has boba in it, and it's probably just like a milk tea. I'm pretty sure that's probably what that is. Black milk tea with chocolate. Yeah. I probably wouldn't drink this. This isn't... If it has chocolate in it, it's a no bueno for me. But it looks pretty good. I don't know what this booth is. Germany. Okay. So this is Germany's booth. Looks like they have two items. They have red wine braised beef short rib with parsnip puree. I thought this said broccoli. It doesn't. Baby tomatoes, balsamic glaze, looks pretty good, and a black forest cake, chocolate mousse with cherries. No, that's not for me, but that looks amazing. I would get this. This right here is a winner for me. I would get that. Let me see. And this one's only $8. I could do that. That looks super good. That looks like mom's, like, Sunday meal or dinner. And then this? No. Black forest cake with chocolate and cherries? Not my vibe. I don't like chocolate, and I don't like candied cherries, so this 100% would not be for me. No, thank you. No. Not for me. But this would be the winner right there. Let's see. All right, we got just a few more. Pop Eats. Let's take a look at that one really quick. This one's not associated with a country. This one is just like it shows up every once in a while for the festivals. But they normally have like pretty good stuff. So this is tomato soup with a grilled cheese. This is like a big hit every time they bring this one out. I don't like tomato soup too much, but I am curious to like actually try this one. Ibby, you're so picky. LOL. I'm sorry. I don't like cherries, period. But I like cake. I had some of that at a Germany restaurant in November. Oh, okay, okay. I am a little picky. I am. I pick my books and my food based on looks. If it doesn't look good, then I'm probably not going to read it or eat it. Let's see. This one is tomato soup with pimento cheese, bacon, fried. Oh, this has a fried green tomato in it. Actually, that kind of pops. This is just a grilled cheese. This one I might have to get because I am a big fan of fried green tomatoes. That one looks good. I'm here for that one. And then this, I kind of want to try this. Rock and dot white chocolate. I'll take white chocolate. And orange mousse. With vanilla bean chiffon cake. I'm gonna try this, probably. That one looks good. They literally say don't judge a book by its cover. I do. And I'm sorry. I judge books by their covers. If it doesn't have a cover that, like, grabs me and, like, pulls me into the world, I ain't here. You know, like, I won't read it. Like, I pick my anime that way, too. If the front cover of the anime doesn't have, like, a really good cover art, I probably won't watch it. I'm a hard judge. I hard judge based on first looks when it comes to food, when it comes to anime, books, and manga. Like, I do. I'm sorry. That's me with anime and video games. If it's pretty, yeah, I'm attracted. That's exactly. If it doesn't grab me in the first few minutes of seeing it, I ain't gonna watch it. Like, Suzume, the art grabbed me. It's an anime movie for anyone that doesn't know. We're probably going to watch it in the forest. It's made by the people that did Your Name and a few other animes. And they did so well at bringing the visuals of Suzume to everyone. And I was hooked. Like, I was hooked immediately. But then I watched the movie and I was like, oh, this was kind of bad. Like, I didn't actually like the movie. But they hooked me and I waited and waited to watch Suzume. And then I didn't even really like it, to be quite honest. It's so sad. It's real sad. This is Morocco. We've gotten a few things at the Morocco Pavilion before. I like the Morocco. Morocco Pavilion's pretty good. Let's see. Grilled. I don't know how to say that. I know the chicken, carrot, chickpea salad, and garlic aioli, I think. That doesn't look too good to me, but I would actually try this. I would try it because this pavilion, I like the Moroccan food. It's pretty good. They used to have a Moroccan restaurant, but it shut down after COVID. In Epcot, and we went to it, and the food was really, really good. It was very, very good. This is lamb with chickpea salad, and then some more garlic stuff. This just looks like the same version of this with lamb. I would probably get this version as opposed to this version. Excuse me. And this is actually really, really good. So I had this probably a few years ago, the stone-baked Moroccan bread with hummus and all these little dips. I had this, and this was very, very good. The bread is kind of, like, puffed up. So it's not like a... It's almost like a tortilla whenever you, like, if you put tortillas, like, in the pan and they kind of like puff up a little bit. That's kind of what this is. It's not like a bread, like a normal bread where it's like thick. It's just kind of like a pocket almost. And then you just dip the stuff inside. And this is good. This is actually super good. What is this? Chocolate. Chocolate cake with pomegranate mousse and pomegranate whipped cream. I like pomegranate. I like that fruit, but I don't like chocolate. But this is a very pretty, like, very pretty dish. 100%. If it didn't have chocolate, I would get that. But it's gonna taste like chocolate, and I'm not a big fan of that. What we got here? I don't know what pavilion this is. Oh, this is the Encanto pavilion. So it has more like Spanish kind of food, Colombian kind of food. And I've had both of these items, I believe. So I've had this right here, which is just basically chorizo potato empanada. It was pretty good. I'm not a big fan of mustard. So I just kind of like scraped the mustard off because I don't really like it, but it was pretty good. And then this, I've had several different versions of this cake, passion fruit, jelly, mango, cheesecake. It's very, very good. I'm 100%. I'm going to get this, like, without a shadow of a doubt. I always get something that is like passion fruit or any type of mango, passion fruit, those like exotic kind of like, well, mango's not super exotic, but passion fruit's exotic fruit. I really, really like those. And then you have to make sure to eat the flower because flour is edible too. I'm not a fan of mustard. Yeah, I've never been a fan of mustard either, to be honest. Pina colada. But yeah, I'm 100% probably going to get this. I get this dish almost every time, but it always looks different. Yeah, get some pepperoni pizza. That's so cursed. It's so cursed. My stepson said I was un-American for eating my hot dog with just ketchup, and I was like, sorry, I can't do mustard. I don't do any kind of condiments. I don't do ketchup, mustard, mayonnaise. I don't do any of that stuff. But if like the mayonnaise is in like chicken salad or something like that, I'll do that. But like I'm not big on ew. How much you know? That's funny. But no, they change it and it looks different every year, but I'm 100% getting that. That looks phenomenal. And I get it every year. More festival offerings? Let's see. Let's take a look. Oh, this is like a cafe that they have. Yippee! Oh. Alright, that's a spicy drink. This is just they have a lot of chocolate. A crazy funnel cake sandwich. If you like funnel cakes and you like sandwiches, you too can have a funnel cake sandwich. I don't think I would eat that. I just want to see what's in between. A mini funnel cake sandwich with vanilla ice cream, rainbow whipped cream, strawberry sauce, and powdered sugar and sprinkles. Whoa! that's a little wild. Oh, I will love that. Probably minus whatever the red drizzle. It's strawberry, and I like strawberry. Strawberry is pretty good. Hey, you got a sunflower. Let's go, Relic. Yeah, I'd probably get that. So this is pistachio coffee cold brew. I kind of want to try that. I know Tay would try that. I know that 100%. But yeah, like, that's a whole situation right there. Wow. That's sweet. I could feel, like, the kids, like, glitching out eating this. Oh, man. All right. But that looks like it's, best of the fest, always the beef Wellington. The cake is always a big one, big staple. This was the best one. Apparently, France has the best one. The one we were like, man, I don't know about that little cake. Apparently, it has the best one this year is France. With this whole situation, I don't know about all that. strawberry is decent. If it was cherry, I'd be like, nope. Yeah, I like strawberry, but not cherry. I like cherries if they're fresh cherries, but I don't like the candy cherries at all. I'd be cute if each stall was based on Disney film like France and Ratatouille and Yeah, so normally they do like they do that sometimes. To be honest, they do it sometimes. They don't always like incorporate like the characters. Like one year I went and I got Ratatouille and it was like, you know, Ratatouille's Ratatouille, and that was pretty good. They do stuff like that occasionally. But not all the time. But this is like, apparently this is amazing. To be fair, I would try everything and end up in a good coma. In a food coma. Yeah, no, the festivals are always such a fun time. Like, to be in the parks. There's normally four festivals at Epcot. The art festival starts us out for the year, and then we'll do a review for all the festivals. I'm gonna start doing this on the channel because I enjoy it, and not everyone gets the Disney experience, and I understand that. And it's just a fun way to like share with you guys, like, you know, this is what I get to do sometimes on the weekend. Not all the times, obviously, because it is expensive, and I do realize that. And we normally only go to the festival. Like, the festival goes from January 12th to February 19th. So we normally only get to go one time to a festival. We normally don't ever do, like, 2 days at the festival just because it is expensive and it is pricey. But it's fun, and I figured bringing this to the channel might be a good, like, you know, a new segment to the channel to show you guys, especially since I'm probably going to go this weekend. But yeah, I enjoy it. But the art festival starts us out. The flower and garden will be next for spring. That's my second favorite. The art and the flower and garden. The flower and garden has beautiful food normally. and then the food and wine. And then Festival of the Holidays. And that is for Christmas and, like, you know, the holidays and stuff. And then the food and wine is normally like in November-ish, and they're pretty good. Companies be like, you have to try new food for experiences and actual experience payment successful place. Interpin. Yeah, no, it is true, but I like to take advantage. So I am an annual pass holder for Disney. And we normally try to go to Disney at least once a month because that's something we enjoy. We enjoy that a lot. And it's fun. We do rides, but for me, I love the food and the festivals and stuff like that. And we really, this is something me and my husband enjoy. We're not like gung-ho Disney adults. Like, we are Disney adults, but we're not like, you know, like the ones that are like super, you know, ecstatic. We're kind of like on the DL, you know, and there's nothing wrong with people that are like super, super Disney adults either. But yeah, it's just a fun little thing. And I figured I'd share that with you guys. And then I'll share with you what I actually got at the festival on Monday, probably. I'll share with you guys the food I actually got. So you got to see all the food at the festival. Now, on Monday, I'll probably, if we get to go, that is, hopefully we get to go. We've been having some car trouble. But yeah, I'll show you what I actually got, on Monday. So that should be fun. Back. What up? Welcome in, Lag. How are you today? We just went over the Festival of the Arts at Epcot, all the booths. So we were looking at a lot of food, Lag. A lot of food. You know what I mean? We were into food coma. But we're gonna go ahead and switch gears. And we're going to go ahead and probably play some Pal World right about now. Hopefully, I'll be able to get it. Hopefully, I'll be able to get it to load. It wasn't loading for a second. Let me go ahead. Go back to my chatting screen so, you know, you guys aren't super flashbang. Okay, let's see. Yeah, we're going to get back into some Pal World because it wasn't loading for a second. So, I hope it launches. Let's see. Pal World, are you working? Sounds like a Harry Potter spell. Popper spell? Harry Popper spell? Oh, no. Alright. How are you doing today, Lag? Let's go ahead and go for Pal World. Alright. Jago, thank you so much for the 15 bitties. I do appreciate sure you did playing Power World as well. Ah, okay, okay. Yes, 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 yes. My help! Cookie, they're gonna keep you on your toes, you know what I mean? They're gonna keep you on your toes. Let's see. Hopefully we can get this game up and running. Before I, like, flashbang you guys again, I'm gonna try to make sure the game's running really quick. I'm excited. I want to show you guys my world. Like, the world I'm playing in, my personal world, and then we'll go over to the follower world. Alright, one second. Where am I? Okay, is this my house? No, this isn't my house. Okay, wait a minute. I was going to show you guys my personal world and the progress I've made on it, and then we'll go to the follower world. I was like, where am I? What am I doing? Who am I? Not the squats. I hate it here. PC game. Let's go back to Power World. Alright, there we go. There's some Power World. Get some exercise. What the heck? Alright, we'll get some exercise. Apparently, that's what we're doing right now. Woo-woo! Alright. Let's see. Alright. I'm gonna put my Be Right Back screen on, and I'm gonna do my squats and my push-ups. And I'll be right back, you snake! I'll be back.
Do the Me Horse Babies. They have sliding doors. No! But it's work! Ah! So stressful! I'm gonna lose my horses. No! No!
I curse everything.
It's fine. Just don't go outside, okay? Outside. Hello? Are you okay? I told you it's these goofy skins.
The sword.
I want the old Soon fish sticks so bad, or the princess fish sticks.
Well, I'll keep that in mind, 90.
Here. Cause like it's a whole, don't worry, I'm gonna die. But it's like a whole structure. And it's like, you see? But there's no guardians in here. There's no guardians. So we're a little like what the heck, you know? And then I'm gonna go ahead and go over here and I'll show this off while we're on stream still. All right, we got about 3 minutes in the world, guys, and then we're gonna be shutting the world down.
Okay, we are back. I had to get my cup real quick in the kombucha because I don't have my, I didn't have my, my kombucha out because they say kombucha's nastier if it's hot.
You just about killed me. That one took a little bit longer than I was expecting. Okay. That's fine. Welcome in, Jim. My poor ears. I'm so sorry. Welcome in. Welcome in, fish. Ooh. Y'all had me on my toes there a little bit. Okay. I wanted to show you as I'm out of breath. I wanted to show you guys all of the new pals I have. They're all starving. That's fine. So I showed you, I got this chick. She's one of the bosses. Come here. Look at me when I talk to you. She's running away. But anyways, she's one of the bosses that you can fight. And get. I also got this guy. He's also a boss that you can get and fight with. He's pretty cool. We're gonna put you back in, big bud. And then, let me see. I got some more I wanted to show you guys, like, what I have. I got this dude. He's super cool. He's like a... I think I shared this one in my Discord. He's like a... He's like some kind of horse. It's pretty cool, though. Oh my gosh. I'm out of breath. Your girl's not in the best shape. I'm in a shape. It's not the best shape, but it is a shape. Alright, you guys have seen this one. I was trying to see if I got anything else that's like super cool. Oh, I caught one of these big guys. I finally got him. Caught one of the, like, the derpy dinosaurs. He's pretty cool. Because far look at each other then. Did you hear us? I don't know, maybe. I'm trying to think if I have anything else I was gonna show you guys. I found some pretty wild pals, like, out in the wild. Like, I was gonna show you guys those. I got this guy, too. He's pretty cool. Got a good few. Codex. So, I found this guy out in the wild. And, like, he's insane. Is this him? No, that's not him. There's this guy. He kind of looks like a Pokemon, this one does. No, it's not this. This guy! I found this guy out in the wild, and I was just like, huh? What do you mean? He's amazing looking. Also, I've been trying to catch her. I haven't been successful. I got her. She's pretty cute. And then this is what the cat looks like. She's super cute. But I went into this area over here, and I'll tell you, like, where I got those two. So, like, the big, like, the night horse or whatever, I got him over in this area. They're pretty cool. So I opened up this area right down here. And then that's pretty much all I've done since then. But this area is insane. Like, there's some pretty big monsters out here. And I'm getting to the level, like, I just made my first, like, my first pew-pew. So, like, that's pretty cool. That's pretty neat. But yeah, this is the progress of my world. But I, like, it took me forever to get this dude. And then it took me forever to get this one. Which, these two are pretty cute. Like, I really, really like that cat one. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and go back into our world. So if you're on Game Pass and you're wanting to play Game Pass PC, you're more than welcome to join us today. You know,
bye, have a great time.
I need to fix my eardrums. Okay, sorry, Jim. I didn't mean to get your eardrums. But yeah, you're more than welcome to come and play with us as long as you're respectful of all the stuff, you know, and stuff. And don't like grief or anything. You're more than welcome to play. And I'll be copying and pasting the code. Let me go ahead and put this into Let's Play. So that's gonna be the code. I don't have Powell, so you guys have fun for me. Yeah, I think you would actually... I don't know if you would like it. I take that back. I don't know if you would actually like it or not, J-Girl. A part of me doesn't know if you would like it or not. Am I falling full blast and I hear screaming in my ear? I'm so sorry, Jim. Oh, by the way, on stream, on Steam, pals, you can join other people's lobbies, which I think is cool. Oh, so kind of like the whole Ark situation. Like, kind of like you can join, like, people's worlds in Ark. Is that what you mean? Alright. Let's go ahead and get this egg really quick. Nice. How come? What do you mean? Hey, welcome in! Kitten, welcome in. We're playing some Pal World. If you are interested in playing, you are more than welcome to, as always.
Very important people.
Very important people. Yes, yes, yes. I'm doing super, super well. I'm just chilling. We are working on our base here, in the Pal, in the world of PALS. We're working on our base. And, yeah. How are you today, kitten? What are you up to? What's going on in the kittenverse? Alright. Let's see what we gotta do next. I'm not entirely sure. I'm not super worried about them. We gotta make a cooler box, and we have to make a sphere workbench. Okay. Oh, what's going on here? Oh, no.
What do we call it? F around and find out? Well, you done F around and found out.
Yeah. 1 second. I'm doing good, just chilling right now, but should probably be getting ready. Ah, okay, okay. Ah! Whoa! Oh, what are you getting ready for, kitten? What are you getting ready for, dude? I think we're good, like... Yeah, he's, like, all the way over there. We don't have to go for him. He's, like, all the way over there. Yeah, we're good, we're good, we're good, we're good. We don't have to go over there. Alright. Let's go ahead and eat some eggs really quick. Let's get our pals up. Alright, technology. What do we have to open up? Nothing normally. Doing Uber Eats deliveries on Friday nights. Okay, okay. Yeah, I didn't get into Uber Eats, but I did get into DoorDash. But DoorDash is kind of like, it's not as hot as it used to be. Like, used to, you could, like, go. Yes, yes, yes. Thank you so much for networking. I do appreciate that. It feels more like a job to do, what is it called? What is the thing called? It feels more like a job to do DoorDash now than it used to. Because used to, you could just play. Like, used to, you could just play. Not play. Just go Dash. And they didn't have a schedule. But now you have to have a schedule. And I really, really don't like it. I've been playing Minecraft Java. A friend of a friend has a modded server. Ah, okay. I've been playing some Minecraft 2. I was working on something. I didn't quite, like... I'm pretty much finished with the project that I've been working on, so I haven't been on Minecraft since then, to be quite honest. I've been playing a lot of POW. You know what I mean? Like, this game has been fun to me, and I've been enjoying the grind. Like, I really have. Like, normally, I don't enjoy... like having to grind a game out. I really, really don't enjoy it, but this one has been good. Like, I've enjoyed this one because the progression system is just so easy, and it doesn't feel bad, you know what I mean? Yeah. What's up? I was like, who's shooting at me? Yeah, what's going on? What you got? Yes? Here. Where's our, like, oven? Oh, I got a bird, dude! Let's go! I'm gonna put him in my team because, like, that would be super cool. Nope, that's how you burn out on a game real quick, so I don't grind anymore. Yeah, the thing is, like, I used to, like, thoroughly, like, enjoy grinding games a lot. But, like, now I definitely don't. Like, it's not, like, my favorite thing to do. Definitely not. Fair enough. Yeah. But this one feels good. Like, I don't feel like it's like a chore to grind this game, because like I'm just waiting for the next level to do this, to do that. You know, so like that's what I like about this game, is they don't overwhelm you with like 50 things you have to do all at once, and like you've got to do them. This game doesn't do that, and that's what I really enjoy about it. Let's see. Oh, we got a lot of eggs. We need to incubate some more eggs. Yeah, well, we're gonna do some more eggs really quick. There we go. What I'm trying to do today in this particular world, let's see, what are our tasks? Cooler. So what does it take to make a cooler? That's what I want to know. Oh, cooler's all the way down here at 13. So we have to make this one, and we have to get to these two levels. So I kind of have to grind a few levels to get anywhere. So let's go ahead and go to sleep for the night if we can. I think he's AFK. Oh well. We'll go ahead and go to the workbench and fix our tools really quick, and then we can grind out some stuff. But I think what we're gonna do next week, I think that we're going to play some cozy games, and I'm also going to be taking a look at the new Poppy's Playtime. I'm pretty sure, but I'm just going to have to be a little bit careful, because I think that the new Poppy's Playtime deals with some a little deeper subjects, and I don't know if we're going to bring it to the channel, but we'll see. I was actually going to play that today. I think I'm going to get dressed now. We'll be back. Okay, all good.
Bye, have a great time.
All good, kitten. Have a wonderful day if I don't get to talk to you again. Yeah, I think he's AFK. Alright, so I'm gonna go grind some levels really quick while he's AFK. Have a good one. Yeah. Got a chicken. I'm sorry, little chicken. I don't mean it. There's no hate or harm to you. We'll be back. I'm only getting dressed. Okay. No worries. I've been in PJs all day.
Bye, have a great time.
I've actually been trying to get it sounds super silly, but I kind of live my life in PJs too. But like this year I've been trying to like actually get up, get dressed, like, not in PJs or stay in PJs. I've been taking my medicines, like, I have to take my allergy pills and stuff like that. I've been trying to be, like, a lot more, like better than that. I have to take an iron pill, too. So I've been trying to get, like, a lot better at doing that kind of stuff. It's just, like, a work in progress. Oh, a depressor. I want him. No! You killed him! This is why we can't have nice things. It's because you like beating people up. Better get in that ball. You're not gonna see another day if you don't get in that ball. Okay. I'm like, you better do it, you know what I mean? Oh, but beating people up is fun. I'm like, what happened to this man? Yeah, we're just doing the level up right now, pretty much. This poor kid. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. No. I'm trying to get my dinosaur back. Get him. You can get him. There you go. I'm sorry. He's a little aggressive. Please excuse him. He's a little aggressive. Pika and Spark looking at me, telling me, "That's not nice." It is it. It's definitely not. Help! You want me to catch? Oh, I'm coming. You want me to catch him? I got you. Yeah. We gotta do the level up. Unfortunately, like, just battling and stuff is, like, the best way to get level ups. Let's see here. Alright. Also today, guys, don't forget that we are having anime night tonight. So starting at 5, in the Discord, if you're interested, and one of my mods, you can do exclamation point Discord in the chat. We're going to be showing a kind of cute little anime. Nothing too deep. It's just kind of a one-shot anime. There's only 11 episodes. And you're more than welcome to check it out. We'll be playing it in the Discord. The information is all in the, is under events in the Discord. We're gonna be watching Blue Spring Ride. So, it's an anime that I've actually never finished. It started out super good, and then something came along and probably and took my eye. But it is a subbed anime, just keep that in mind, so it will be subtitles that you'll be reading. But there's only 11 episodes, and we're gonna be watching 6 of those episodes tonight. And then we're going to be watching the rest of it next Friday. So just keep that in mind. So if you're interested and you like anime, if you're into kind of like romance kind of anime, that's kind of the vibe of this one. Kind of like a school life, slice of life kind of situation. And it's really good. It's like, I don't normally watch subbed animes just because I don't really like them. Because I don't like having to read all the time. But if it's something you're interested in, yeah, definitely feel free to come check it out. We'd love to have you over there. For sure. Alright. Let's pick up some more berries here. Got some berries going here. Is that a monster? Oh, it's a rock! I'm like, haha, is this a monster? That is 100% a rock. That was a rock. Not a monster, a rock. I was going a little crazy there. I need my... There we go. Eat this chicken. We'll get this little guy over here. But yeah, all the information about, like, the anime 2 is also posted in the Discord. So you kind of get a feel for, like, what you're watching or whatever before we start it. And that's going to be starting at 5 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, so my time. But if you look at the event on Discord, it will show in your time what the event is. Like, the wrestler... Oh, wait, what? Did I miss something? I probably missed something, 100%. The weather? Like, I missed something. Who even are you? I don't even know who you are, buddy. Get out of here. Alright. Get some mushrooms. Go ahead and eat these really quick. Give some to my little dinosaur. The rock. I was trying to be funny. Oh, okay. Yeah, the rock. I was like, wait a minute. Hold up. Did I miss something? Yeah, no. I've actually never seen the rock in person. I've seen the Undertaker in person, but not the rock. I've seen Batista in person, too. The big old dude. Oh, my goodness! Jeez Louise, you're just destroying everything in your path! What if I wanted to catch him? And you destroy him. This is why we can't have nice things. Relic, dude, what have you been up to? What have you been playing lately? What's your go-to game right now? Since you're not super into Power World yet. This one kind of looks like a little bit of a Pikachu, kind of. But it's not. Let's see here. Oh, yeah, that one kind of looks like a Pikachu, but it's definitely not a Pikachu. Let's see. I missed it. Yeah. I might be able to find another one. But this game is like, if Pokemon were real, like, this is what it would feel like. Looks like a settlement over here. Maybe let's see what this is. Well, I've been playing three or four games at the moment. Oh, what games are you playing? I kind of went on an insane ride last night. So I actually stayed up last night. I haven't been up. I've been going to bed. So I haven't like, you know, I haven't been playing at night. But last night I stayed up and I played Overcooked 2. I played one map for probably about 2 hours because we couldn't make 3 stars on it. And if you want to know, like, what insanity actually feels like, it's that. Like, insanity feels like playing Overcooked for 3 hours straight on one board. One board for 2 hours. And one looks like a... Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Yeah, yeah. The guys down on my shelf are selling rare pals. Oh, really? What kind of pals? Is that, I don't know. Oh, look, these kind of, they're like little porcupines. I'm sorry. Oh! My goodness! She destroys everything in her path. Like, stop being so strong, please. Overwatch, Dragon Age Origin, Warhammer, 40K Dark, Tide, Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Oh, okay. Were you here when we tried Assassin's Creed, Relic? I can't remember. So, we tried Assassin's Creed, on the channel. And it was a little rough. Like, the game was a little... It was a little rough. Let's just say that. I was like, I don't think we can play this game on the channel. It was a little dark. It was a little too dark. I feel like I'm going crazy. Like, I feel like I hear somebody behind me. Let's see if we can catch her really quick. That'd be pretty cool if we could catch her. Nice, nice. A level 14? Oh, nice. Not bad, not bad. The only thing about this, J-Girl, if you haven't seen anything about Power World, so the pals don't, like, evolve or anything. They're just, like, the animals of this world, kinda. And... It's everything, like, a person would want in a Pokemon game, but it's not a Pokemon game. Level 14 can start the base upgrade if we want. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Go ahead and start it. Go ahead and start it. That's fine. Yeah, I can see that. I have finished Assassin's Creed Valhalla, but I remember one side quest is listening to ask me through. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Definitely, yeah. I think it was Assassin's Creed. It wasn't Valhalla. I don't remember which one it is. But yeah, I was like someone got like jabbed, like stabbed in the face. And I was like, We can't play this on my stream. We'll play it on other people's stream, but definitely not a forest stream. I was like, this is definitely not okay for the forest. I'll have to come home very soon because I'm starting to run out of arrows. It's little monkeys. It's nice. I'm sorry, you're my next victim. I don't mean it. I wish I had, like, a better weapon. Like, that would be so nice. Nice, there we go. Oh, he's eating it! Oh my gosh! You don't eat... That's can't... You can't do that! I just watched a drama go down. The drama. Hey, husband. That was actually insanity. What the heck? Alright. Okay. Alright. Let's go back and take a look at the upgrades for our base. Let's go this way. Them dogs look like the... Like Canrock? Okay, so this is like the best way to explain it, Dark. Like, a lot of the pals in Pal World look like if there were different Pokemon meshed together, that's kind of what they look like. Does that make sense? That's 100% like the easiest way to tell you like what they look like. They just look like Pokemon that have been meshed together. Like, for instance, like, I don't have, like, all of the pals opened up. But, like, look at... I mean, the one that's running right beside me, tell me that's not a Pokemon. Then there's this one. Look at this one. This one kind of looks like a Dragonair with legs. They definitely have a bee Pokemon, you know? Monkey... This one looks just like that ugly fish Pokemon. But yeah, there are a lot that kind of like resemble Pokemon. But it's interesting because like this game, like Nintendo is trying their hardest to like sue Pal World. But like the only thing is Pal World is nothing like Pokemon. Besides the catching them aspect about them. Like, the pals don't evolve. They don't evolve. They work on your farm. So they do, like, tasks and stuff for you. And, like, it's completely different from Pokemon. Like, this game is more like Ark than it is Pokemon. Because, like, it was explained to me whenever I first, like, was, like, looking at it or whatever. It was explained to me that it was basically Pokemon with guns. And, like, it's really, really not. Like, on the spectrum of things, it's not. Like, it's definitely not Pokemon with guns. It's Ark with Pokemon. Is that, like, that makes more sense to me saying that than anything else. Where you want this. You can put it wherever, Cookie. That's fine. It doesn't matter. You can put it wherever. Yeah, I did get it. I find it funny. Almost looks like a copy of Nintendo's homework and tweaked it for the PAL design, at least. Yeah, it really does. Like, it's super funny because, like, That is, like, literally, that's how it, like, that's what it feels like. But the game is more like a easy version of Ark with Pokemon, and the Pokemon can have guns. There are, like, gym fight leader, like, there's, like, not gym leaders, but there's, like, boss fights and stuff you can do. And stuff like that, but, like, other than that, like, it's not, like, you can hatch eggs. Other than that, like, it's nothing like Pokemon. In my opinion, it really isn't. I've heard the comparison. Yeah. And it's interesting, like, that these people, I know, like, there were some controversial stuff going on about the game. Like they used ChatGPT or whatever to, like, create some of the monsters. But, like, I don't think they're gonna be able to, I don't think, a part of me just doesn't think that they're gonna be able, like, Nintendo is gonna be able to sue them. But I don't know, what do you guys think? Do you think that Nintendo is gonna be able to sue Powerball? Do you think it's like, do you think that the game is enough like Pokemon that they're gonna say, oh yeah, we're gonna be able to, like, have a lawsuit against Powerball? I truly don't think it is. I really, really, truly don't think they're gonna be able to. Now Ark. You could say I feel like Ark would have more of a, would have more of, like, a lawsuit against them than Pokemon. But that's just me. I don't think so. Yeah, I really, really don't think so. And if Nintendo is smart, like, I feel like they're smart. I feel like if they were able to take Power World down, I think a lot of people would be very upset. And I also think people would, like, because this game, like, has had so many copies sold, XYZ. I think people would be very upset if this game was taken down. And I don't think it's going to get to that point. But I think people would be very upset with Nintendo by a long shot, because it's a good game. Like, you know, it actually is a decent game. Let's see, let's go ahead and put that there. Nintendo lawyer will find something. Probably. As much as I love Nintendo, you know. Yeah. Nintendo and Disney are so notorious for, like, being so completely salty about this kind of stuff. And it's like, I understand how they could be upset. But, like, on the other side of it, I'm like, but why didn't you make this game? Like, if you knew that, like, this is what people wanted, then why didn't you make the game? You know what I mean? Like, that's just my thought process on it. Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking, too. Like, how can Nintendo, like, have this idea of egg critter capture? Like, is that, you know what I mean? Like, is Nintendo exclusively only allowed to have the Pokemon formula? Like, why can't, like, other games have that formula? And they do. They just don't look like Pokemon. Ark, you can get dinosaurs and they can serve you and do things, I guess. I don't really know. I didn't make it that far in Ark. My Ark days are very far behind me because I actually hate that game. Like, to the center of my core, I actually hate that game. Like, it was just, I just felt so useless, so pointless in a world full of, like these giant dinosaurs and getting stomped by dinosaurs. Like, it wasn't a good feeling, you know? But they start you out. They show you a big guy right at the very beginning. So this is where you start at the game. And then that big old mammoth that we saw earlier, that's the big guy right here. And that doesn't feel bad. He doesn't, like, you know, he doesn't attack you and stuff. And I don't feel like I'm being trampled every 2 minutes by a freaking dinosaur, you know? You can put your tame into cryopods. Oh, okay, okay, okay. I don't actually know what that means. Be 100% honest. I mean, there's Digimon, and Digimon is owned by Bandit, not Nintendo. Yeah, that's true. That's true. I forgot about the Digimon situation. Like, that is super true. I totally forgot about Digimon. I have, like, a Digimon, like, plushie. It's, like, a pink blob, and it has, like, antennas. I have that. I don't really know what he is. I never really got into Digimon. Nor was it created by Game Freak. Yeah, that's true. That's true. I didn't think about it like that, you know? But I think it's interesting. I think all of it. I'm insulted. I'm sorry. I wasn't... I was on the Pokemon craze. I wasn't on the Digimon craze. But I don't play either of them now, so, you know, it is what it is, you know? Yeah. It's just a pink ball with antennas. Like, that's all it is. But yeah, the progression system in this game feels so much like... It just feels better. Like, you go over here to your little workbench. This is what keeps your pals, right? So you go over here. We're gonna go ahead and upgrade the base. You go here, and it gives you, like, tasks that you can do to upgrade your base if you want to. Like, thanks, Cookie, for getting the box. Let's go. If you want to, right? So it's like, okay, you can make a cooking pot if you want to, a wheat plantation, or you can build a mill. So how do we do that? We just go over here to technology, and you basically just have to be the level, and you have to use your skill points, you know, of course. You have to use your skill points to be able to, like, open up these things. And, like, here's the cooler box that we just created. We gotta do the mill, we gotta do the wheat plantation. This is level 15, and then a cooking pot is level 17. So the progression system doesn't seem, like, horrible, you know what I mean? I have pizza rolls! I had some beans and rice today. It was pretty good, pretty good. I was here for the beans and rice. Alright, pick up these. And then basically you grind those levels. If you want to, you don't have to do it if you don't want to, but you can. And you just kind of do. I'm going to get someone else that can do some more wood. And then see, like, the pals, they go do tasks and stuff. Like, they just kind of do whatever. I need to make another bed really quick for one of these pals. There we go. Oh, I need some more wood. Let me get some wood really quick. It's beans and rice. Is beans and rice certain type of beans? So, basically, the type of beans that I normally get... Oh, man. I have too much weight. Okay, what do I do? 1 second. Alright, One second. So normally I do like white jasmine rice with my beans. Like for this particular dish, I did northern beans. So normally when I do like northern beans and stuff like that, I do white rice and I'll put like ham or bacon in them. And that's something that I enjoy. And I normally just do canned. Like, I do canned beans for stuff like that because it's a super easy meal. And it's a really good meal. And I also have, like, onion normally on the side with that. I probably should have taken a picture. Aw, dang it. I'm carrying too much again? Darn. Okay, thank you. Yeah, I'll take a look at it. But yeah, that's, I like doing like a pot of beans like that whenever it's kind of chilly outside. I normally do that. Okay, gotcha. Look at the pretty deer thing. Yes, isn't it cute? I love this one. I can't pick up that wood. Yeah. Let me get this one really quick. There we go. I've got the same one you do. Yeah, the ice deer. I want to get the ice deer, dude. Like, that's the one I, like, want so, so bad. Oh, look at the flowers. I love it. It's so nice. Let's go. I'll put, like, his bed right here. He can be right next to the fire. How cozy. I'm late. That's okay, Stardew. There's no worries. Stardew, if you like anime, we're gonna be watching some anime in the Discord. So if you're not a part, I think you're a part of the Discord. If you're interested in watching kind of like a romance anime, we're gonna be showing one in the Discord at 5 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, my time. I'm trying to like let everybody know, just in case you guys are interested. If you're not, that's totally cool, but it's something that I've been trying to do, like, get back into, like, show, like, you know, doing anime and stuff like that. Like, that's something I kind of want to be on a regular basis. Aw, thank you so much for the lurk, J-Girl. Yeah, I'll take a look at the things as soon as I can, J-Girl. Let's see. We're gonna put the iron ingots right here. I have, like, a chest that has, like, just the organs. Is that kind of creepy? I don't have Discord, sadly. Oh, okay. That's okay. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that. Yeah, so if you're ever interested in the Discord, sometimes we play, over there. It's rare now that I go into the Discord and just play a game, but I do occasionally, so we do that over in the Discord. And then we watch anime in the Discord, too. And that's, like, the best way to get a hold of me. Like, I don't normally answer anything else on any other social media platforms. But, Discord is, like, normally the best place to catch me. Alright. I'm gonna go to sleep really quick, Cookie.
Bombastic side-eye.
Criminal offensive side-eye.
Do you understand?
Do you understand? Go to the next day. But I really would like to unlock all the pals. Oh my gosh, I really would like to unlock like all the pals and stuff. I think that would be super, super cool. Dude. Open. Because there's like, I think if I'm not mistaken, there's like 100 pals in this game. Which is actually crazy to me. All right, let's see here. I think we're gonna go ahead and make some more, what are you doing? Well, what the heck? All right. We're gonna make some more arrows because I really, really, really need some arrows, like, desperately. So we're gonna make some more, and then we're gonna go out exploring a little bit more to see if there's anything else that we can find. Alright, I'm gonna let my sheep work on those really quick.
Get some ears.
Get some ears? Oh, okay. What kind of ears do you want? What kind of ears are you looking for? Give me a theme and I probably have it. Can I make a saddle? Let's see. If I can make a saddle, that would be so helpful right now, is to have, like, at least a saddle. I need to get one of these guys. Okay. Yeah. What do I need for this? I need some iron ingots and I need a horn. What do I need a horn for? Dude, I discovered some cool breeding mixes. Oh, how? Like, what do you mean by that? Can it be a surprise? Yeah, we'll do a surprise. Okay, I'll be right back. I'm gonna go get my ears real quick.
Hey, you know, if anything, I'm glad we made it to day 26. And I'm still looking for a flower. Oh, look at that. It's not a flower. Yay. Look at that. You thought there was gonna be a flower there, didn't you? It wasn't. Psych. No flowers. Hey, at least those guys aren't chasing me.
He's just chilling. He's like, hey man, can you open it up here? I'll open you up a path. There you go, buddy. Boom. Just for you, Mr. Turtle. He's like, no, I don't wanna go, it's cold. No, don't make me.
Oh, he's a mammal.
But yeah.
Oh wait, hold on. I got this.
But we definitely get that a lot.
I am 24 years old.
Yeah, I'm also 20. It's fine. We have 13 minutes. 13 seconds. It's fine!
Okay. So, in honor of the Chinese New Year, we're going to be going with the Mulan ears. Welcome in, Coco Bunny! How are you? We're going to be going with these. It has like a little dragon in the center and a little fan. I don't bring these out often because like this is actually a metal piece. I think. No, it's plastic. Okay. So it's just, it like digs into my head, but you know, this is a good set of ears. I don't wear them all the time though. Let me see if I can get my camera like so you can see them. Be right back. Okay, all good. How are you, Coco Bunny? Welcome in. My name is Ibby, if you don't already know me. Variety family-friendly streamer. And today we're playing some Pal World. Alright, there we go. Those are so pretty! Yes. Yeah, the Chinese New Year's coming up. It's the Year of the Dragon. I'm pretty sure this is like one of those dragon dogs. I don't know what they're actually called. But this one's a pretty good set of ears. It's, oh, okay. So, yeah. No, it's the left one, Jay girl. It's the left one. If you're still here. Those are so pretty. I'm doing good. I followed you from seeing videos on YouTube, and you helped me be able to make a raid command with my emotes. Thank you so much. Absolutely. I answer any questions. Like, if you guys have, like, questions for me and stuff, I always tell people to like join my Discord. I have a stream advice like section in my Discord, and I answer questions. Like if you guys have them, I always answer those questions. I don't gatekeep stuff because I want people to be as successful as they can be. You just have to get there by your own means, but I can help you like learn how to do stuff, you know. And it's you know, it is what it is. I can help in any way that I can, but I can't help you, you know, in regards to, like, you know, what you stream or how you stream it. But normally, I try to be as helpful as possible. I got a giant chicken pal last night. Yes! Look at this guy! He's a whole situation! Look at this man! Look at this distinguished little gentlewoman. It's a girl. Look at this distinguished little lady chicken. She's so glorious. Could you help me craft? Yeah, I got you. If you have to make a breeding farm at your base, you have to make some cakes. I'd say 2 pieces at best for one process, and then 1 male, 1 female. But there are some really interesting mixes I've found. Oh! Post it in the Discord, lag. Do it on in all other games. Post it in the Discord. I would love to actually see it because I just created something last night in my world and I don't actually know what it is. So I'm kind of like, I don't know what I just made. But hopefully it's not going to like it's not gonna do something bad. Like, I don't know what it is. I'll show you guys what it is in a second. Let me get this saddle made really quick with Cookie. Sometimes it takes so long to craft stuff. Alright. Let's go. Nice. I got this last night. So I think I'm on like level 22, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, it doesn't even show what it is. Okay. Yeah, it doesn't even show what it is. It's like some big machine. Like, I don't know what it does, though. I need to get a saddle, dude. I need to get a saddle for my deer, too. Can I just ride my deer as well? I don't know. Let me see. Oh, yeah, I have to have a saddle, too. Okay, that makes so much more sense. Like, for example, if you put any oxygen or ice pellet at breeding farm, it'll give you ice version. Oh, that's what you mean. Okay, yeah, I have seen that. I have seen that. Look at this poor little man. He's so upset. I'm sorry. Okay, I'm sorry. Gotcha. I know what you're talking about. Now, I was like, they make other things. Like, how? But I get it now. Alright, I gotta get one of these, like, really, really bad. Alright, let me go get some iron really quick. Because they have, like, different versions of the monsters. And, like, they're just, like, different colors. And it's just a different, let me see. Oh, there's normally a mining thing down here. Let me go see if I can find something to mine really quick. I need some iron. Really bad. Normally there's like an iron here. Cookie must have gotten this iron already. But yeah. I know that horse thing, I got a big horse. Like a fire horse. And he has two different versions. He's like a dark type. And he's also I think he's just a fire type. A dark and a fire type. Dude, where's all the iron? Am I like missing something here? I know I gotta get some like And I only have 40 arrows? Where did all my arrows go? I thought I had a lot of arrows. What the heck? That's crazy. Look at this guy. I have one of him. I'm so excited. It makes me so happy to have him. Dim arrows go fast. Yeah, they do. The crossbow, you don't have to use the crossbow. Like, I feel like the arrows don't, like, go as much, like, with the crossbow. I don't know how to explain it. I guess it's just because you have to do less shots with it. But, like, I was just making arrows. I don't know where the heck they went. Oh, wow. I gotta go get some deer, though. I do know that. Those deers are over there running away from me. I gotta get those deer.
Come back! Be my friend!
Trying to see. I don't have any, like... Listen, I understand that you're probably having a good day. Alright? I get that. But I need your horn. Whoa. Have you ever considered not doing... Whoa! That. You missed. Trying to bring my other pal out! No! Stop getting me! I know nothing! Stop it! Stop! All right, there we go. Whew. That was a little bit of a struggle. Ibby, committing crimes against your own. I'm sorry. I just need a saddle. I need a saddle so bad. Just pretend it's like a donkey, okay? Like it's just a donkey. You know what I mean? Like, just pretend it's a donkey. If you pretend like it's a donkey, it makes you feel better. Yo. Actually, chill out. Actually. Whoa there. Fido. I just need your horns! So there aren't different pals, they're just another color. Yeah, I think they're just another color, like, and they're depending on what color they are. I think that that's what determines. Where is my bird? Where are you, you weenie? Don't run away. Thank you. Jeez Louise, Bill. That's a bummer. I thought the breeds made them new pals. I mean, they might, and I just may not understand. Maybe they do make them new pals. I just don't understand. All I want is to get a saddle. Like this, all I want is a saddle. I'm sorry, I didn't mean it. If you just don't think about it long enough, kitten, it won't hurt you. It will go all away. The bad will go away. So I got, let me see what else I need. I got the horns. All right, so I need some fragments, and then I guess I need some ingots as well. But yeah, no, in my main game, I've been really, really like, I've been grinding the levels just so I can get that ice deer. I want that ice deer so bad, dude. Like, words cannot describe how much I want that ice deer. The ice deer is super, super cool. There should be another. Yeah, we'll go down here. There we go. Nice. Hey, we're level 12. Let's go. Yep. Nice. Dream, welcome in! How are you? Dream, we were talking about Disney. I was hoping you'd be here this morning. We were talking first. Supreme pizza and chocolate coconut candy bar ice cream. That's a little wild. How are you, dude? What's going on? But yeah, we were like looking at food pictures, Dream. Like, we were hard looking at some food pictures today. Like, there was a lot of food pictures today. Yo, gamer, welcome in. How are you, dude? Yeet. Oh, the cat, change up. Yeah. So what I'm probably going to be doing is, before every festival, I'm probably going to be like showing, the festival food before I go to the festival. And then I'll show you guys like what I actually got at the festival and stuff. Just been a kind of hard month. No. Obviously, that's totally fine. Like, Dream. Like, I just catching you up on the stuff. You don't have to be here at every stream. You don't, you know, obviously. That's a no-brainer. Like, life happens, and I almost canceled stream today just because there was some stuff I was having to take care of, and I just didn't know if I was going to be able to take care of it before stream. I was okay till, wait. I was okay. I went to A&E. I don't know if I know what that means, gamer. But you guys talked about food without me. Yes, I am sorry, but the food talk was pretty nice. There's a lot of good food at the festival this year, and I'm super excited to, like, I'm super excited to try it out. Oh, okay. Well, I'm sorry to hear that, gamer. I hope everything's okay. Is everything good on your end? I broke my... Ow! What the heck? That just sounds awful. But I'm okay. Well, I'm glad you're okay, but like, what? How does one break their knee? That's insanity. I try to be here. I love your streams and all the awesome people here. I'm glad. Thank you, Dream. I do appreciate it. I like having a space that everyone can feel included in. We don't do politics. We don't do stuff like that. And we're just here to play games. And I love that about our group. That we're here to have fun and play games. The community is an awesome community, and I'm so glad to have, like, all my loyal, you know, viewers and stuff like that. You guys are awesome. I'm okay. I got a bike injury. Gotcha. I do apologize that you had your bike injury. I have a little bike story for you guys. I think I've told this on stream before, but, like, when I was a kid, I didn't know that you weren't supposed to break going down, like, a hill or a mountain or whatever. And, like, so we had, like, this, like, hill by our house, at the house I used to live at. And it was pavement, it was a paved road. I was at the top, and I put my brakes on at the top, and I just went tumbling down the hill. It was terrible. And, like, I was with my dad, and my dad was totally oblivious to what was happening. He didn't even look back. He had no idea that I had fallen down this, like, this massive hill for a kid. And it was pavement, because I braked. No one said, don't brake on a hill, Ibby, and I didn't know that. I was a kid. I came home, and I was all banged up and scratched up, and my dad's like, what happened to you? He never looked back once. I was like, what the heck? The Firefox thought it was done working. Yeah, get to work. I was biking when a car overtook me, but hit me into the curb, and I crashed into... Oh, no. Yo, that's not good at all. What the heck? My husband has a... He used to have a motorcycle, and someone ran him off the road one time. When he was on his motorcycle. Like... messed up his handlebars, dropped the whole bike on the ground. People just don't look out for, like, bikers and, like, motorcycles and bikes. People do not look out for them. And it's so bad. Like, I'm really sorry, though, that happened to you, gamer. I really am. I broke my arm from being in a bike. My shorts caught in the seat wrong, and I fell over, put my hands through my head, and I ended up breaking it. Yo, that's actually insane. I did not break anything as a kid. I've never broken one bone in my body. I was not, like, a super reckless kid. Can't be, like, motorcyclist or cyclist. Yeah, cars, they definitely don't. They really do not, like, look out for people. And I will say, on the opposite coin of that, like, whenever you see a motorcycle and they're doing something super, like, stupid, like, I hate when, like, you know, the, like, really fast motorcycles, they'll go in between cars, you know, like, on the line, they do that. And it's like, okay, like, if you're doing stunts like that, something is bound to happen. Like, you gotta be safe if you're gonna be doing stuff like that. You cannot be doing that, because that puts other people in danger and yourself. So, like, that's one part about, like, cycling and stuff. that I'm like, well, I don't know about that. You shouldn't be doing that. But no one deserves to be ran off the road, even, you know, for stuff like that. Just in line. Yeah. Wait in line. It's really simple. Yeah, but they don't. They literally, some of them literally don't. Welcome back. gotcha. She was, your Nana rode a motorcycle? Someone did that yesterday. The traffic was bad and the motorcycle drove in the middle of the road with... yes! That scares me a lot because, like, the thing is, like, what if for some weird reason, like, this is super weird, super, super random. Like, what if someone opened up their car door and you were going in the middle line and you happened to, like, hit the car door? Like, that just freaks me out. Like, why would you put your life in danger? Or the people that ride in the emergency lane, like, the cyclist emergency lane. Like, those people are silly, too. Like, that is just beyond wild to me, you know? She used to take you riding when you were a kid. Yeah.
Well, hi there. How's it going?
Yeah, no, I rode, motorcycles with my uncle and some of my cousins whenever they had motorcycles. And then I never actually rode my husband's motorcycle. He didn't have like a back seat, but my uncle and my cousin, they had back seats to theirs. And like during the holidays, they would bring out like their motocross, like stuff. They would bring out like the motorcycles. They would bring out like the four wheelers and stuff like that. And we would like go out to like the boonies and like ride them and stuff. But I met my husband like a lot later on in life, and he just had his motorcycle. He had a motorcycle and a car at the time. And he just never got, like, a back seat. And then he ended up trading in his motorcycle for, like, a Jeep. But we don't have either now. We don't have a Jeep or a motorcycle. We just have a car. has no one ever seen that scene in Spider-Man 2 where Peter is trying to deliver in pizza? Which Spider-Man 2? Which one are you talking about? There are a lot of Spider-Mans. You got to be very specific in which Spider-Man you do be talking about, because there's quite a few Spider-Mans. I have. I want to learn to ride one day, but even my parents put up riding after us because it's a risky business. Yeah, and that's the unfortunate part, Dream. It's like, it is a very risky hobby if you're into it. I don't know if you would call, like, motorcycles a hobby. You doing a 2-hour, I'm not sure yet, Cookie. I haven't decided yet. It is a very risky thing to ride a bike, and like, I think my husband is a little bit more hesitant on riding his bike just because he was ran off the road. Literally, he was ran off the road and, like, dropped him and his motorcycle, bended up his, like, his handlebar things or whatever, dented his motorcycle, and I think, if I'm not mistaken, it was bad, like... He called me, and this is before we were married, I think. It may or may not have been. But yeah, it was pretty bad. And, like, he wasn't doing anything wrong. People just weren't watching out for him, you know? The original. It's the only one that has it. Okay, gotcha. I don't remember much about the Spider-Man movies, Kitten, just because I was slightly traumatized by the Green Goblin. Like, the Green Goblin scared the pants off me, dude. Like, actually scared the pants off me. Okay, be right back. Okay, all good. I haven't seen the second one with Garfield or the recent ones. So, I've never really... This is so controversial. I've never really liked Tobey Maguire's. Like, Spider-Man... My favorite Spider-Man out of all of the live actions has 100% been Andrew Garfield. And... just because he seems nerdy to me, and we've had this, like, we've had this discussion before, I think. He seems the most nerdy to me out of all of them. Toby, you seem too old. Like, he was just too old. And then Tom Holland is too cool to me to be Spider-Man. Like, he just has too, like, a, like, I'm a cool kid vibe, you know? So I've always liked Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man so incredibly much better than Toby or, Toby. It was me. That was a yawn if I've ever heard one before. But yeah, I've never been like I like Tom Holland, but his Spider-Man, he's just too cool. I'm sorry, I meant Tom Holland. I've only seen the first one. Yeah. Like, what? Still working. So much for the Prime sub, Star. Thank you, dude. I truly appreciate it. Yippee! Yes, yes. Thank you so much. You reached a sub goal today. Thank you. I really appreciate that. It's truly. The subs, as you know, subs help keep the channel going and stuff like that. It helps bring new content. It helps buy new games. New things like that, and so I really appreciate it, dude. I only saw Andrew Garfield in Infinity War and Endgame. Ah, okay, gotcha. Let's see. Let me read Lag's comment really quick. Andrew Garfield is the best Spider-Man as far as fighting style and quips during fighting. Tom Holland is the best Peter Parker easily. And Toby has the best Spider-Man villain to me in the movie, being Doc Ock and the Goblin as well as... Okay, I can agree with that. I can agree with that statement, Lag. I can 100% agree with that. But yes, thank you, Star. Thank you so much, Star, for the sub. I do appreciate it. Toby is what we grew up on. Andrew delivered tears. And Tom, he looks more like a high school student. I love them separately and appreciate all the movies. Yeah, this is the way. That was 100% the best description. That was like one of the best descriptions I've heard so far. Lag, one second. Sorry. That's one of the best ways to describe it, in my opinion. Like, 100%. One of the best ways I've ever heard it described. That's 100%. Andrew fights like Spider-Man using his spider senses. Yes. Tom Holland just acts like he's Peter Parker, and you just can't top those villains. Yep. Yeah. Andrew's getting his redemption tears. Man had me in tears with his acting. Yeah, okay. So it might sound super, like, sad or whatever. Like, I know, like, there's been sad stuff in every Spider-Man movie, but Tom Holland, when he spoiler alert! If you haven't seen Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man, I'm sorry, there's about to be a spoiler alert. When he loses his Gwen, that was rough, in my opinion. That was one of the roughest. Like, that was rough. Like, just the... You know, like, that one was hard. So heartbreaking. Yeah, no, that one left me... That one kind of messed me up because, like... It sounds super weird and corny. But, like, and as I've gotten older and I've experienced life a little bit more, like, thinking about losing, like, potentially, like... Anybody that's close to me like that, or especially like my husband, like I literally could, like, that's wild. Like, his was truly... That one was rough. You know what I mean? Like, that one was actually rough. Never expected it to be the... Yeah. Like, that one kind of messed me up. I'm not gonna lie. That one for sure messed me up. I really enjoy Into the Spider-Verse movies. I haven't watched the last Miles Morales. I watched the first one last year. So I haven't, like, actually gotten into the newer one. But I really want to see it because I really liked Miles Morales' Spider-Man. Those are great. My son and I can watch those on repeat. Yes, yes. The music is a vibe. Yeah, for sure. The second one is really, really good. Yeah, I would love to see it. Depresso went to bed upset. I'm sorry, little man. Let's put you back in there so you don't have to do any more. I'm sorry, little man. Like, I'm actually sorry. I don't know what to do for you at this moment. I need another minor, though. There we go. I'm gonna play some Pal World. Okay. Yeah, we're probably gonna be done here in a bit. I wasn't entirely sure what we were gonna do or how long we're gonna go. I've been capping my streams back to 2 hours, and the reason for that is I'm easing back into stream. So that's helping me ease back in. And I'm really focusing. I told people this already. I'm really, really focusing on content creation because, like, we're really trying to grow this year as, like, a community, like, and monetize. Like, that's the biggest thing this year is monetization and getting out there so that people can see us and know, like, you know, our community and potentially become a part of our community. If you have Netflix, the second one is on there. Oh, okay. The Miles Morales, the new one. I didn't know that, but I'll have to get Netflix just to see that. Or I could just rent it, probably on YouTube. Annoyed we don't get both. What is Miles Morales on, like, the first one? What is that one on? Is that on HBO Max? What is that on? They have them on Disney? They have the Miles's on Disney? No way. No, they don't. That's okay. Thank you for the hydrate! Alrighty. Let's take a look at something real quick, like... Okay. Let's see. What? We got that. We got that. We leveled up, so let's see what we can do. Oh, never mind. They don't. I was gonna say, I'm pretty sure they don't have that. Like, a part of me is like, yeah, they might have it, but I was like, I'm pretty sure they don't. Welcome in! How are you?
Oh, I'm not gonna make it.
Thank you so much for the raid, Books and Keyblade. I already gave you a follow at some point in time. I can't remember when. But thank you so much for the raid. Thank you for bringing your community in. Hi, how are you guys? What were you guys doing? We are having a raid battle. If you would like to participate in the raid battle, you are more than welcome to! !emote with your favorite emote. We'll get you into the raid battle. But for all those that are new that are coming in with the raid, hello, welcome in. My name is Evie. I am a family-friendly Christian streamer, and we're safe for work, so you can pull us up anytime. If you have younger audience, younger children, this is a good place for them to watch as well. I play a lot of cozy games and a lot of first-person shooters, but today we're playing Pal World, because I have been on the Pal World craze as well. Welcome in, gaming. How are you guys doing? What were you doing? This is a books raid! Yes! I love it! Thank you so much for coming in, guys. Alright, let's see who's in Sparks be fighting. Yes! Let's see who wins this raid battle real quick. Oh, J-Girl's the only one in, it looks like. Alright. Thank you so much for playing, guys. I do appreciate it. We're gonna give this win to the critters. Thank you so much for playing with us. Let's see. I'm trying to see what you guys are doing. No, I totally get that. I'm in the POW world. What do you mean? What do you mean by that? What do you mean by that? The POW world challenge too? Oh, are you just like doing the grind? Is that what you're talking about? Are you just grinding the game? Yeah, we've just been kind of just chilling on the game. Like, the base that we have open up for our followers currently is, let me see. I have, like, my own personal world, and I have, like, we are at level 10 base, and we have a world that we're playing with people with as well. Just obsessed, Ella. Okay, I was like, there's already a POW world challenge out there? What do you mean? Yo, welcome in, Gaming with Foster. Hello, happy Friday. Thank you so much for the happy Friday. Also a big fan of King Arts. Okay. I'm sorting Pokemon cards at the moment. I feel that. I never got into Pokemon cards. Like, I collected them, but I never played Pokemon the game. Like the card game. I was into Yu-Gi-Oh cards over, like, Pokemon cards. But I did collect them, but I just didn't play it. But we did some Disney because we're Disney Dreamlight Valley fans and I don't want to get behind. Well, you actually just missed it. We were actually going over the Disney, the food and not food and wine. The arts festival at Epcot. We were looking at all the food. We're big Disney lovers as well. I'm actually going to Disney tomorrow. Hype. You know? Yeah, I don't play the TCG, but I collect a lot. Yeah, gotcha. I'm addicted to collecting Pokemon cards. I got into the craze of, like, collecting Pokemon cards, Yu-Gi-Oh cards, and then I was also into these other cards. They were called Belisera cards, and they were, like, horse cards, horse trading cards. And I loved them. It was a fun little, like, hobby, for sure. Nice! Yeah. How much do you have? Are you talking about how much do I have, meaning, like, cards? Like, what are you talking about? I've got a PSA 10 Umbreon worth... Whoa! That is actually... Okay, you're talking about Pokemon cards. I don't actually have any more Pokemon cards anymore or Yu-Gi-Oh cards anymore. I got rid of them all. But I used to collect way back in the day. It's just something I don't do anymore. But... I was always excited, though, to, like, play, to, like, do Pokemon, like, cards and stuff like that, because I always just liked the artwork. I didn't know anything about, how rare or anything they were. Oh, let's go, gaming, let's go. I have too many to name. Yo, that's insane. Towards your PC? Yo. I hate to raid and run, but I need some food. Absolutely. I am so sorry, Books. I forget to tell Raider, the streamer, I'm so sorry. Please don't feel like you have to come in and stay. Definitely go take care of yourself. After stream care is super important. Please take care of yourself. We're going to be ending here soon for ourselves. But thank you so much again for the raid and bringing your awesome community to this little side of the Twitch. You know what I mean? Talk to you soon, Books. Yeah, absolutely. his cards, or at least the special ones. Yeah. So I was into, I bought, like, a pack of cards. It was when 5Ds came out, the Five Dragons, like that, like, show. When that one came out, I bought the Black Rose card set that was dedicated around the Black Rose Dragon. And, like, I loved it. It was amazing. It was my favorite. But yeah. I haven't been into cards in a very long time. I think it's just because, like... I think it's because I spend all my money on video games and Disney, to be quite honest. Like, we play Disney Dreamlight Valley here, as well. And like, if I'm not gaming at Disney or playing Disney Dreamlight Valley or at church, like, I have like a few like hobbies in life, as you can see. But I did hear that they're having like Disney trading cards come out now or something like that. That's insane, Gaming. That's actually insane. That's super cool, though. You too, not Umbreon. Okay. Yeah, my best friend collects the Disney cards, too. I haven't gotten into collecting them, but I wouldn't mind collecting them. But I just haven't done it yet. There used to be these cards at Magic Kingdom that you could get every time you go. And I probably still have some of them somewhere. But every time you could go, you could, like, go and get these cards for free. Like, a pack of cards. And I don't even know what happened to them. I don't even know if they still do it anymore. But that was pretty cool. Like, that was super cool. Gotcha. I do have a P4 Pikachu. Gotcha. Sold 100 bucks a piece? Yo. That's insane. I wish I was lucky enough to get one of those, like, cards to sell that many times. That would be so cool. I have not been that lucky in my endeavors. But I wish I could be. Right, we're gonna go ahead and go level up really quick. We gotta get the cooking pot. Fast travel. Let's go over here. Oh, really? The one in the museum? Yo, I don't think I'm supposed to be here. That bear's about to rip me a new face. I'm out of here. Like, your girl's done. I'm out. I'm not doing that. So I got a few. Oh, okay. Nice. We have a lot of people, actually. We have a good few people that are from the Netherlands here in this community. Good few people. I'm sorry. It's just business. I just need to level up. I'm so sorry. Yo. That's actually so cool. Charizard, whenever I was into Mewtwo. Whenever I was into Pokemon, Charizard and Mewtwo were my favorite Pokemon. Like, actually. No, don't get me. Alright. We're just leveling up. It's just business. I'm so sorry. Look at him swimming. You can't get away from me. I'm sorry. Oh, I still need to tell you my type. Like, what my favorite type of Pokemon was. Water and Psychic. Those are my favorite. Not water. I hate water type, actually. Fire and psychic. Those are my favorite types to mess with. So I stopped playing around Black and White. No, X and Y. It was X and Y. I played X and Y. And it was just too easy to me, in my opinion. Oh, remember. Just remember, gamer. PG language. Fire and psychic. Yeah, that's insane. I bought, like, that's actually insane. Bought it for 60 bucks a few years back. Yo. I had a feeling that was possible. Yeah, it was always fire and psychic. That was my go-to. Whenever, like, my team, like, whenever I played the games, my whole team, consists of a Charizard, a Raikou, a Mewtwo, a Rayquaza. Wait, How many do you have on a team? Is it like 5 or 6? So I had Charizard, Rayquaza, my brain just died mid-sentence. Charizard, Mewtwo, Rayquaza, Arceus, and probably Raikou or Suicune. It was one of those two. That was pretty much my whole team. It feels so good to be with my kind of people. Absolutely, gaming. Absolutely. It's fun when you buy cars or cheap cars in the fight. Yes, absolutely. Six on a team. Then what was my 6th Pokemon? I don't remember. I don't know what it was. Okay, gotcha. All good. But yeah, like, so, it was super weird, but like, I had this one. We just become best friends, yep. Oh, thank you so much for the follow, dude. I appreciate it, gaming. If you're interested, I'll make you a little origami stars. Thanks for the follow. Let me see, where's my command? Just let me know what color you want, and I'll make one for you. We have pink, blue, white, green, or yellow. In good condition. Okay. Let's see. Pink, please. Okay, I got you. Here it is. All right. So we're actually going to be ending pretty soon, only because... we have anime night in my Discord. So let's go ahead and switch over this screen really quick. One second. Let me go ahead and go back out really quick. I'll make your origami star. Anime night is actually starting in like 30 minutes. Over in our Discord. So if you're interested, you're more than welcome to check it out. We're doing like a romance anime this time. Absolutely. Okay, let me see. And you're more than welcome to continue, like, your conversations, you know, and stuff over there, and, like, the just, you know, whatever. But anyways, this is what the pink paper looks like. I'm gonna give you this one. It has, like, super cute little flowers on it, and then I'll make it into a thing. Anime night? Discord, yeah. Nah, we're not doing JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. I didn't really get into that anime. There's just something about it. I didn't get into it. But... Anime night, there's going to be details in the events in the Discord. You're more than welcome to go check it out. But it's about to start in 30 minutes. I just looked at the clock. I'm like, oh, I'm over time. All right. So let's make this for you real quick. True. Yeah. Yeah. So your Discord looks awesome. Thank you so much. Just keep in mind. Bye. By star, come by. Oh no, you said you don't have Discord. I need to up mine. Yeah, we've been a growing community. So I try to change stuff up. We have Discord games and, you know, stuff like that. In there. Bye, Ibby. Bye. We're gonna be in the Discord. So if you want to watch anime, you're more than welcome to come by. I'll be starting it as soon as I can. But thank you. Just keep in mind, we are, like I said, a PG Discord, so anything you post, that's what it looks like before I pop it up, gaming. Anything you post needs to be force friendly, as we say, so if you can't say it or see it in a kid's Disney movie, then it doesn't need to be posted in the forest. Alright, and then that's what it looks like whenever it becomes a star. It's like a 3D little star. Thank you so much for the follow. I really appreciate it. Yeah, I thought so. Just liked books. Yeah. We also have like a book area too. So if you like want to share, I think we have the book area still. So if you want to share what you're reading, everything just needs to be kid friendly. Just because we do have younger people in the Discord. So you know, and I put it in this little mushroom jar. So we just try to be mindful of that. And when I say younger, I mean, obviously, it has to follow the TS, you know, the guidelines of Discord and stuff like that. But just keep that in mind. But anyways, thank you so much to everyone who came out and enjoyed the stream. I do appreciate it. Gaming, thank you so much for the follow. I know Books isn't here, but thank you so much for all the raiders that came by and enjoyed talking with us. We truly appreciate it. Got all the respect. Absolutely. We hit a sub goal today. I truly appreciate that Prime Star. Thank you so much. What else we got? We got J-Girl with the biddies. Thank you. I do appreciate that as well. It always means the world to me. Your subs help bring content to the channel, stuff like that, you know. It helps keep the content flowing. Yeah, all other appreciation. Yeah. Thank you. I do appreciate it. We do have a verse of the day. I am a family-friendly Christian streamer, as I say, so I do give you a verse. I will never put my religion down your throat, but I do like to give people, you know, a little good, you know, in their life. Let's see. Let's see if we can find a verse for you guys real quick. I'm Christian too. Yeah, absolutely. I never push my religion down anybody's throat, because there are a lot of people that aren't necessarily Christian in the forest, and that's totally okay. Like, that's okay. I will never push you to do anything you don't want to do. That has to be something in your heart. You know what I mean? Let's see. I'm trying to find a good one for you. I know that we did this one, I think, on Wednesday, but I really like this one. This is the confidence we have in approaching God. If we ask anything according to his will, he will hear us. And that comes from 1 John 5:14. That was the verse we did on Wednesday as well. And I really liked that one. But anyways, we are going to see if we can find someone to raid out to. Let's see. Hopefully someone playing some Power World. That would be awesome. Let's see. Who can we find? Okay, we're gonna be raiding here. No, let me see. Let's see here. I'm trying to find someone to raid out to that maybe we haven't raided out to. Give me one second. I do apologize. Like, I like to make sure that wherever we send you guys, like, it's gonna be, like, appropriate and stuff like that. If, you know, sometimes we do raid out to just other creators, which is totally fine and stuff. But today, I kind of want to raid out to a Power World streamer. Let's see what's going on. Sorry. I try to be very careful with where I take my community, because I want people to, you know, I want it to be okay. Let's see. All right. So we're going to raid out to this particular individual. I don't know them. I don't believe, but they're in the same, like, they're in the safe streamer, category. So we're going to raid out to them, really, really quick. Like, all right. This is the, person we're going to be raiding out to. FYI. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. What J-Girl said. We're going to be raiding out to this individual. I believe they're also a Christian streamer as well, but we shall see. Hopefully everything, you know, goes well and stuff like that. This is the raid message for subscribers. This is the raid message for non-subscribers. Please make sure, like, we use the raid message and stuff like that, just because, like, when we bring hype into a chat, like, that always is really, really good. You know what I mean? Like, a good hype is super, super awesome. But anyways, as always, stay safe, stay awesome, and we will see you next time here in the forest on Monday. Probably, I don't know what we're going to be doing on Monday. But anyways, bye! Thank you for streaming. Absolutely, bye!